So all of you, welcome to the session. Today we are going to talk about TDS equations. Let us see how can we derive TDS equations one by one. Okay, now the first TDS equation. So let us see, initially entropy is a function, S is a function of temperature and value, T comma V. Now differentiate this function, then we get ds equal to so dou s by dou t at a constant volume dt plus dou s by dou v at a constant temperature t and dv. Okay, now multiply t on both sides, we get tds equal to t into dou s by dou t of v dt plus t into dou s by dou v of t dv. Okay, so now we know very well that TDS equal to dq according to thermodynamics second law. Differentiate with respect to T and also at constant volume. T into here we'll write, so here we'll write dou s by dou t at constant volume v, and here it is dou q by dou t v. This is equal to cv. Right. Understand. Now substitute CV value in above equation here in this place, then we will get that the TDS equal to CV plus T into dou S by dou V of T, so dV, dou S by dou V of T dV. Now according to Maxwell's thermodynamic second equation, what is that Maxwell's second equation, dou S by dou V. So that is equal to dou P by dou T. Here it is constant temperature, here it is constant value. So this is what Maxwell's thermodynamic second equation. Now substitute this one here, then finally we will get the TDS equal to, here we will get the CV plus T into dou P by dou T at the constant value into dV. Right? So this is what first TDS law. This is what first TDS law. Okay, so what is that? TDS equal to CV. Here we forgot the dT is there. So dT plus, here we have the dT, right? dT plus CV dT. So plus T into dou P by dou T V dV. So this is what first TDS equation. Understand? You have to remember this one. TDS equal to CV dT plus T into dou P by dou T V dV. Okay? Right. Now let us see second TDS equation. Right. Here, let us assume here S is a function of temperature and pressure. Now to differentiate on both sides, what we get the dS, and here we get the dou S by dou T of P dT and the plus dou S by dou P of T dP. Okay, so right. Now multiply T on both sides, what we get the T into dS is equal to T into dou s by dou t of p dt plus t into dou s by dou p of t dt. Understand? So we know very well TDS is equal to what? TDS is equal to dq. Okay, so now differentiate this one with t, and what we get the t into, so dou s by dou t, take partial differentiation, dou s by dou t at a constant pressure p, that is equal to dou q by dou t at constant pressure p. See that dou q by dou t of constant pressure is nothing but Cp. Specific heat at a constant, specific heat capacity at constant pressure. Right? Substitute this one in above equation, we'll get the TDS equal to Cp and dT. So plus, here we have the term T into dou S by dou P T dP. Understand? So we know very well. Now, from the Maxwell's third law, from the Maxwell's fourth law, so here from Maxwell's fourth law, we know that dou S by dou P equal to dou V by dou T Okay, right, here it is constant temperature, here it is constant pressure, we have minus. Okay, now substitute this value here, then finally what we get? TdS equal to Cp dT minus, here we have the term T into dou V by dou T P dP. Okay, so this is what? Second's TdS equation. This is what? Second's TdS equation. So TdS equal to Cp dT minus T into what? Dou V by dou T P dP. Second's TdS equation. I have to remember this one. Now, next, third TdS equation. Now here, entropy is a function of pressure and value. Here, what I am taking here, entropy is a function of pressure and value. Instead of taking P, here we have to take PV. Entropy is a function of PV. Now differentiate and what we get there, ds equal to, here it is, dou s by dou p at constant value dp plus dou s by dou v at constant pressure dv. Okay, right, all right. Now what we have to do here, let us multiply with T on both sides. That means what we have to take, TdS. Multiply with T on both sides, TdS equal to T into dou S by dou P of V dP and plus T into dou S by dou V of P dV. Okay, so from this equation, I'm going to write this one as TdS equal to T into dou S by dou T into dou T by dou P. Right? Dou S by dou T into dou T by dou P, where it is constant value. And similarly T into, so dou S by dou T into dou T by dou V, here it is constant pressure. Just I am writing this one as. Okay, now we know that this value is equal to Cv, right? So TdS equal to Cv dou T by dou P V plus this value also can be written as Cp, right? Cp, specific heat capacity at constant pressure. This is what specific heat capacity at constant value, Cp, and here it is dou T by dou V P dV. So alright, so we got TdS values. Okay, now, so this is what third TdS equation. So I have to remember TdS, first TdS equation, second TdS equation, and this one is finally third TdS equation. Now show that Cp minus Cv equal to Cp minus Cv equal to T into dou P by dou T V and T into dou P by dou T V and dou V by dou T at constant pressure P. Alright. So we have to show this one. And also we have to show that Cp minus Cv equal to T into dou P by dou T V and dou V by dou T P equal to R. We have to show that now. Okay, so for this what we have to do, we have to take S is a function of temperature and value. Okay, so now differentiate this one. What we get there, ds equal to, right, dou S by dou T at constant value dT plus dou S by dou V at constant temperature dT. Understood? Now, what we have to do here? Here it is V. So, divide with dT at constant pressure. So, what we get there? dS by dT at constant pressure we have to take there, P. So, that equal, here it is dou S by dou T constant value plus here is dou S by dou V T and dV by dT at a constant pressure P. Okay. All right. Now, so what we have to do here, multiply with the t on both sides. What we get the t into, here it is, we have to write in terms of partial differentiation. In terms of partial differentiation, so here it will become like this, dou, okay. So t dou s by dou t of p, and t dou s by dou t v, all right. So plus, here it is dou s by dou v, t into dv by dt p. Okay, now what is this function represents? TdS is equal to dq, right? TdS is equal to dq, and from this one t into dou s by dou t, that equal to dou q by dou t, all right. So at constant pressure p, if you write p, it will become cp, right? Similarly here, TdS equal to dq, that is equal to t into dou s by dou t at a constant value v, and that it can be written as dou q by dou t v, that equal to cv. In substituting above equation, in this equation what we get there, we'll get there finally cp equal to cv plus, okay, so in this place you have to substitute Maxwell's law. Okay, you have to substitute Maxwell's equation. So after substituting Maxwell's equation, what is that? Dou s by dou v equal to dou p by dou t at constant value. So that means what here? So here you have to write Maxwell's law. So dou s by dou v constant value t equal to, so here I am substituting, and dou p by dou t at a constant value. Substitute in above equation. Finally, what we get there? Cp minus Cv equal to, we get there, so dou p. So here, alright, we have one more function here. It is t is there, right? T is there, na? Well, yes. Here we have p, because we multiply t on both sides, right? So here it is t. So dou p by dou t, constant value. Here it is dou v by dou t at a constant pressure. So this is what Cp minus Cv equal to t into dou p by dou t constant value into dou v by dou t at constant pressure. Right, here we took there, this is a function of dv, and take differentiation on both sides, and here we have to do partial differentiation with respect to t, and then we'll get this function. Here we have to substitute the TdS. With the help of this equation we get Cp. So t into dou s by dou t at constant pressure can be Cp, and this can be Cv. Substitute Cp, Cv here, and with the help of Maxwell's equation, where dou s by dou v at constant temperature is equal to the dou p by dou t at constant value. Substitute this one, and finally we get Cp minus Cv equal t into dou p by dou t at constant value and dou v by dou t at constant pressure. Now we have to show that this one is also equal to capital R. So with the help of Pv equal to RT equation, we know that Pv equal to RT. So from this one, P by T equal to R by V. P by T equal to R by V. Otherwise, here at a constant volume, at constant volume, here you have to differentiate with respect to T, partial differentiation. What we get there? dou p by dou t. Okay, taking partial differentiation with respect to T. So dou p by dou t at constant volume V. So that is equal to V into R. From this one, dou p by dou t at a constant volume V is equal to R by V. Similarly, take this equation and differentiate with respect to T at constant pressure. So what we get there? P into, so dou V by dou T, taking partial differentiation with respect to T at constant pressure P. So that is equal to, we have only R. So from this one, dou V by dou T of P equal to R by P. Okay, so we got these two equations, and substitute in here in the above equation, then finally what we get there, Cp minus Cv equal to what we get there, T into dou P by dou T. So dou P by dou T is nothing but R by V. Understand? And what about dou V by dou T here also? R by P. Okay, so again we know that PV equal to RT, right? So T into R square by VP. So we know that PV equal to RT, substitute PV equal to RT, then what we get the CV minus TV equal T into R square by PV equal to RT, again substituting. This one cancels, square and R cancels, then finally we have CP minus CV equal to R, CP minus CV equal to R. So this is what our required function, CP minus CV equal to R. So in this way we have to do derive the equation CP minus CV equal to R.